Hey everyone, it's Catherine and John, and we're so excited to be here again with you at Club 56.
Hey, it's great to be with you guys today. I'm excited to see you.
If you were here last week, you might remember that this month is all about getting unstuck. Sometimes we find ourselves in sticky situations, and the only way out is to keep going with a little determination.
That's right. We've all had times in our lives when we need to keep going, do what needs to be done, finish what we started, and not give up. But it isn't always easy, so today we want to talk about that more with you today.
Yes. But before we dig deeper, let's play a game. Today we're gonna play a game called Crushed It or Crashed It.
Ooh, I love it. This game we're gonna play is very simple. You have to choose whether the extreme sport, the trick, is landed, which is crushed, or not landed, which is crashed, based on the video clip that we are gonna show. It's really simple. Are you ready?
Here we go.
All right, let's check it out. Clip one. I don't know, Kath. That's pretty epic.
Ooh.
Now it's their job.
Ooh, crushed it or crashed it? What do you guys think? I think crashed it.
I'm gonna go crushed it.
Here we go, let's see.
Oh, the suspense is
That's
killing
insane.
Me.
That's insane. I could never do that.
Did he crush it?
He crushed it! All right, if you guys chose crushed it, you get a point.
Nice.
All right, here's the next one.
Ooh, extreme winter sports. This is always fun to watch.
Crushed it or crashed it? Ooh, I'm gonna say crushed it.
I'm gonna say crushed it too. They always land. They always land those things.
Let's see. That's a really big hill.
You can do this on the Nintendo Wii too. I don't know if you knew that.
Ooh! Oh! Crashed it.
Wow.
They definitely crashed.
Poor guy.
Summer. That looks like it hurt. All right, here we go.
Oh. Is this
a thing?
This is a semi-truck driver racing right now. This is extreme. No, he's gonna jump it.
I don't.
Oh my god.
Okay, for sure crashed it.
I'm gonna say crashed it too.
There's no way.
What do you guys think?
Crushed it? Here we go.
Live? I wanna know.
Let's see. There's no way you can land that.
Honk, honk. Could you just imagine being there right now watching this?
He's so crazy.
Oh, so close yet not close enough. Did he land it? No.
Oh, no. He crashed
it. That's a crash for sure.
Crashed it. Oh,
and out comes the emergency vehicles to save him.
Oh, wow. Here we go.
Oh, I love snowboarding.
Is this considered snowboarding?
Yeah, this is called a half pipe. This is a half pipe.
Crushed it or crashed it?
Oh, I'm going to say crushed it.
I'm going to say crashed it just to be
crushed.
Different.
I think you crushed it. This is probably at the X Games. So fun.
Crushed it or crashed it?
I used to do this in my younger days. And here it comes.
Crushed it!
Yes. Awesome.
That's pretty impressive.
I love that. Hey, fun game.
Hey. That was a fun game. I wish I could do tricks like that, but I would for sure crash it.
Me too.
Anyways, I want to get us started with a question to get us thinking. Have you ever had a situation where you thought you could do something by yourself, only to realize that you had made a poor judgment call and there was no way you'd be doing this thing on your own?
I am guilty of that, yes. I definitely have had times when that has happened to me. You know, there are a lot of times in life when we rely on something else to help us get through.
Maybe we're tired, so we grab a cup of coffee. I for sure do that. Maybe we're bored, so we grab a video game, or we're moving, so we grab some friends to help. But what about when what we're facing is bigger than these sorts of things, and the answer to what or who can help isn't so obvious?
Yeah, and what happens when we hit the point when we feel like we just are done? If you haven't felt like that yet, you will face a time in your life when you do feel like that, and it'll be good for us to figure out what we can do in those moments.
And when we need to figure out what to do in difficult situations, the best place to start is the Bible, where we can read about some incredible people who faced challenges and relied on God to help. Let's watch the So-and-So Show to learn.
Yes. Thank you.
Oh yeah. Hello everyone. My name's John.
And I'm Brandon.
This is the
Hey buddy, you okay?
So-and-so show! This is the so-and-so show. That's what it is.
What is going on with you?
I haven't been able to sleep lately. I'm just exhausted.
I'm sorry to hear that. Why aren't you sleeping well?
I've been doing this thing to make a little extra money where I teach English to kids in other countries on the internet.
Oh, don't you have to know other languages to do that?
No, it's called language immersion. So I'm just supposed to talk to them in English, and after a while, they just pick it up.
Oh, well, that's really great, but...
Yeah, it's really, it's really great.
Yeah. He still didn't explain why he wasn't sleeping.
It's because I have to get up at 3 a.m. to teach English to kids in China, because that's when it's 4 p.m. in the afternoon over there.
Huh.
Then I take a 2-hour nap before I have to wake up to talk to some kids in Italy.
Wow.
Yeah, it's crazy. Time zones, am I right?
Yeah.
Anyway, another thing.
John. John! Hey, bud. It's time to... Ah, I'm sorry. He's really out. Soccer isn't a real sport.
Who dares?
Great, you're up. We really need to start the show.
Oh, okay. It's time for someone who knows stuff. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I'm sorry, we're not used to having two guests on at the same time. Is one of you supposed to be here next week?
No, I'm pretty sure we're at the right week.
There are two people here, right? Or am I just sleep deprived?
No, you're fine. Okay, tell us who you are and what you know.
My name is Mariah Miller, and I am an engineer for Velcro.
I'm sorry, I am so tired. Which one of you is Mariah?
I'm Mariah.
Oh.
And I'm Cheryl, Mariah's assistant and sign language interpreter. You'll hear my voice, but really, it's Mariah doing the talking. She's the brains of this operation.
Oh, nice.
Okay, wait, so you're this is sign language right now that you're doing?
Yeah.
Do you mind if I ask, how long has she been...
You can talk to her.
Oh, sorry, how long have you been hearing impaired?
I was born deaf. And I can't remember a time when I didn't know sign language. Obviously, I can speak a little bit, but having Cheryl in my life has made it so much easier.
Aw,
thank you.
So wait, you've never been able to hear. That must be hard.
It's hard, but I'm not gonna lie. Having a hearing impairment doesn't make me any less capable than any other person. I go through the hard stuff like everyone else. Hmm. Plus, I try to look for the good in everything.
Oh, how do you mean?
Well, I'm not able to hear now, but I know this amazing, beautiful language, sign language, mm-hmm. And I'm able to focus and keep out input from other people. If someone wants to talk to me, I don't really want to talk to them. And they can't get my attention. Even if they're yelling, I just don't have to look at them.
Oh.
I'm teasing.
Oh.
Okay. All right, we really ought to talk about Velcro.
No. Can you teach me some sign language?
This is how we say thank you.
Oh, thank you. Cool.
This is how we say I love you.
I love you.
Yeah.
Cut.
Got it. It's a little I for I.
Uh-huh. All right. Okay,
L
got it.
For love, ah, Y for you. There. I love you.
That's awesome.
Okay, well, seriously, we're running out of time. Is there anything about Velcro you can tell us really quick?
Velcro was modeled from a burr from a plant that the inventor found that was stuck on his pant legs after a walk with his dog.
Wow. Hmm.
It was also used in the first heart surgery to keep the heart together.
Now that's interesting.
Mm-hmm. And they have Velcro inside astronauts' helmet in case they want to scratch their nose.
No kidding.
You want to try it?
Yes, yes. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I want to try.
Yep, that feels good. It works. It works. It's true.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's like, lovely.
Hey, thank you so much for coming on the show, Mariah, and you too, Cheryl. Thank you so
You're
much.
You're welcome.
Is there, how do you clap? Is there a sign? Yeah. Oh, like that. Okay. Nice. How do you say bye? Bye. Yes. Thank you for coming. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Can't believe I didn't know that.
You know sign language.
I know.
That was incredible.
Yeah, it really was. Now I'm going to take a nap.
Oh, man, we have to.
No! Okay, hold on.
What are you doing?
It's time for me to teach a kid who's calling in from Moldova. Just act like I'm not here. Just keep going. Just act like I'm not here.
So same as usual?
Hello, my name, I'm your teacher. My name is John J. Yeah, what is your name?
While he's doing that.
Shush. Oh, hi, Maxim. What is the weather like where you are? Here. It is sunny.
It's Bible story time with Kellen.
Hey, y'all.
Shh. Hey, y'all.
No, this is ridiculous. Kellen can't be quiet the whole time. We're doing a show. I'm sorry, Maxim.
No. It's fine. I you'll be speaking English this time, won't you, Kellen?
This time, yes.
Great! Maxim, this is your new teacher, Kellen. It's a really long word. Go ahead, Kellen.
Okay, then. Today's story takes place on a day we call Pentecost. This was after Jesus had risen from the dead and after he had been taken up into heaven. And if you remember, before Jesus left, he gave his followers a mission to tell the whole world about him from one end of the earth to the other. Seems impossible, right? Well, wait till you see what happens in this reenactment by your favorite acting troupe, the So-and-So Show Players. On the day of Pentecost, in the city of Jerusalem, the followers of Jesus gathered together in one place.
So, what have you been up to since Jesus died, was resurrected, and then arose to heaven?
I've been telling everyone I know about our risen Savior.
Yeah, nice. Me too. Do you think that we're going to be able to tell the entire world?
Well, I've told about like 50 people so far. How many people are in the whole world?
Millions.
Oh.
Suddenly, a sound from heaven came like a strong wind.
Oh, you hear that?
Yeah,
What is that?
They saw something that looked like fire in the shape of tongues.
I don't know, but I'm sure we don't have the budget to animate it.
They're right. So, the flame separated and came to rest on the followers of Jesus in the house. They were filled with the Holy Spirit.
Oh, wow. That was incredible. C'est magnifique.
Hold on there. Are you speaking a different language? Oh. Mamma mia!
Moi? Oh. It's true. I am speaking French.
And I am speaking fluent Italiano.
Oh, and yet we understand each other. Potpourri, au duve encore.
Bertoli, prego, ragù.
Yeah, so when they were filled with the Holy Spirit, all those gathered began to speak in languages they hadn't known before, not in bad French and Italian accents.
Verdenkam. Nah, I'm speaking Australian. Throw another shrimp on the barbie. Boomerangs.
Anyway, in Jerusalem that day, people from a bunch of other countries had gathered for an annual festival. And when they had heard the Jesus followers speaking their own language, they were amazed.
Wow. That guy's speaking Australian, even though he's not from Australia.
Cheerio! And I do believe I heard a Galilean speaking British at tea time. Spit spot.
Oh, boy. Again, the followers of Jesus were speaking languages they hadn't known before. And to be clear, none of them were speaking English. The point is that all the people visiting Jerusalem from other countries understood what the Jesus followers were saying. So they understood when one of the followers, Peter, stepped forward.
What an entrance.
I got chills.
Let me explain something to you. Jesus was nailed to the cross, but God raised him from the dead.
Ripper.
How wonderful.
Everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Yes.
What should we do?
Turn away from your sins and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then you'll be forgiven and you'll receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Are you in?
Does an emu fly?
Does it?
I don't know. We're in, mate.
That day, 3,000 people from different countries and different languages became followers of Jesus. And they would take the story of Jesus back to their own homes and tell the story in their own language. So people from one end of the earth to the other would hear the good news. Isn't that amazing?
Totally. Really amazing.
And speaking of amazing, let's give a big round of applause for the So-and-So Show players.
Okay, wow, the Holy Spirit helped those Jesus followers do the impossible. I wish I had that.
You do.
Really?
Yeah. Anyone who puts their faith in Jesus has the Holy Spirit.
Then why can't I speak Australian?
First, you can. And second, having the Holy Spirit doesn't mean you have the power to do whatever you want, whenever you want. But the Holy Spirit can help you keep going when things seem too hard for you alone.
That's agreed. Good on you, Kelly. Hey, I can speak Australian. Blah, blah, blah.
We'll see you next time, Kellen. Thanks for the story.
You bet. Bye, guys. Bye, Maxim.
Blah, blah, blah.
Oh, right. Good job today, Maxim. Hey, I'll see you tomorrow for your next lesson. Okay. Bye.
Hi. Are you done for the day?
Yeah, just only 18 more classes to go.
Oh. John, I think that this new teaching job is a great idea, but you might be overdoing it, don't you think?
Are you kidding me? I'm good. The Holy Spirit can just get me through it.
I know, but the Holy Spirit can also help you to be wise. You gotta have sleep, bud. John!
Reveal the question!
The question of the day is, what helps you keep going?
Sometimes coffee. Sometimes running in place.
Oh. What helps you keep going? Not just when you're tired, when things are hard, or when things are boring, maybe. What's something you can do or something you can think about to help you keep going?
Talk about it together.
And we'll see you next time on the So-and-So Show. Are you okay?
I need a vacation.
Okay.
Today we're gonna go over simple objects. Simple objects. Paper. This is a piece of paper. This is a C-clamp device for mobile phones and other electronic devices. Can you say that? C-clamp device
can you say outdated audiovisual tech?
This is a heavy chair. These are rocket boosters for a shuttle program discontinued by NASA. You'll use that one a lot. You'll use that one a lot. It's right up there with where's the bathroom.
Hey, I love the So-and-So Show. It's so, so much fun to watch. You know, it's easy as we watch these videos and read these stories to think to ourselves, well, sure, Peter or John can do something like this. They knew Jesus. But the truth is, these stories are less about the people and they're more about God working through them. And the same spirit that filled Peter, the same spirit that filled the believers in that day, is the same spirit that fills us today. And that can be hard for us to believe sometimes, but it is true.
We might face times when we feel like we don't have the strength to keep going. Like maybe there's somebody at our school or in our family that we really have a hard time showing kindness to. We keep trying, but they never return that kindness. It'd be easier to just give up and avoid them. But the Holy Spirit's power and presence in us helps us keep going even when it's difficult.
Or maybe you're feeling discouraged because no matter how hard you try at something, a sport, a class, a skill, you just keep coming up short and you feel pretty bummed and you want to quit. But God's power and presence in us helps us keep going even when we want to give up.
Today, as we finish our time together, I want you to think about this question. What helps you keep going? For some of us, we might find encouragement from friends or family. Others might listen to a song. But no matter where we find the strength to keep going, the first place we should go is God. Absolutely. Let's pray and ask God to give you the strength you need to keep going. God, we thank you that your power and your presence is with us through the Holy Spirit. We pray that you keep us encouraged and that we find the strength and the power to keep going in these sticky situations in you instead of other things and other people around us. In your name I pray, amen.
Well, hey, it's been great to hang out with all of you today.
Yes, I'm so glad we got to hang out together again. We'll see you next week. Bye.